Welcome back, fans, to another edition of the Adult Demographic. The ICO CJ is here to give you the raw review. Now, I know what you're thinking. There's no green screen, no cool motion backs, all that good stuff. Unfortunately, I've had just a major camera issues. In fact, I'm filming this review on my digital camera right now just so I can get a review out to you guys. But we're going to have everything fixed, you know, for the Thursday show for me and K-Ross's Impact review. So all the bells, all the whistles that you guys are accustomed to, they'll be back for our show on Thursday. Now, WWE Raw's review tonight, this is a two-hour commercial-free show, Toronto, Ontario, Canada. The crowd was live all night long. This was a thumbs-up show for me. I really enjoyed this show through all out. Even the little Geico commercials that they have with Kali and everybody else, it was just fucking good. It was hilarious. Just funny shit. Good humor to mix up with some decent storyline booking. I actually think that Raw did a good job this week pushing towards the over-the-limit pay-per-view. Now, let's just get right into it. We have 8 matches on the card and a great show to cover, I think. And it was 44 minutes of actual wrestling action, which is damn good for a two-hour show, if you ask me. We start off, of course, with the Bret Hart-Jericho promo, and what a way to start off the show. God damn, was the crowd just loving Bret Hart. Absolutely loving it. Good line when he comes up and says he doesn't want to have to hold on to his career like others have in the past. Great stuff. Then Jericho comes down, busting out some lines like, why'd you come back? Calling him the ultimate hypocrite, ego-driven phony. Let's see here. And Bret Hart brings up a good line. We're talking about his brother Keith training him back in the Stu's Dungeon. And if anybody knows the history about his brother Keith, we all know that Keith Hart was a piece of shit that could not wrestle. I mean, Keith and Bruce, neither one of them could not wrestle. Of course, Keith was better than Bruce, but man, at least good thing for Bret Hart to bring up one of the brothers. That was a nice little touch, I guess, for his, I guess not his show on the way out, because he's going to be back, it looks like. And I mean, again, it was a great promo to set up the no DQ match with him and The Miz, and he went from not wanting at all to, you know, wrestle for the belt, because he came out saying his, you know, farewells. Jericho turned him around, and now we got the no DQ match, which is set up for later in the show. Then we jump immediately, and this is great. Talk about living up to the Canadian crowd and making the crowd go crazy. Edge versus Christian. Now, at first I thought, oh, fuck, they're giving away this match for free. How could they give this match away for free? But it's a two-hour commercial-free show. It's in Canada, so it's like a fucking pay-per-view anyways. And you know what? It went for 12 minutes. It was a damn good match. Beautiful ring psychology. Well-paced. Made the moves seem significant. And well-timed reversals. This was a fucking 5-star 12-minute match if I ever seen one. And I'd love to see this match happen again at a WrestleMania. Give them 10 more minutes of time. You know, it's just great reversals, like when his Christian was going for a move and he dove right into the barricade. And then the blocking of the Fulcrum kick by Edge when he stomped him into the ring. Again, a well-played move, good psychology throughout this whole match. Of course, Edge went over with the spear after some great reversals throughout this whole match. Again, this, if you have a chance to watch this match again, I definitely recommend it. Now we go on to Randy Orton here. Comes out after the match and says he's got to face Undertaker. We all know where this was going. I mean, Undertaker comes down. I mean, the ring intro should have been a fucking commercial. In fact, this is what I was doing during his ring entrance. I must have drank like 3 of those by the time he got to the ring. It was a short 30-second match. You know, it was over with. Christian comes in, distracts. Choke slam, boom, match over with. Edge loses. But again, it doesn't do any harm to Edge. He just won a great match against Christian. And the underjobber, that's right, the underjobber gets to have a little bit of a heat there, a little bit of push. Now we got a few promos here before our next match. First up is Maurice's promo backstage. Bringing up Trish Stratus, reading the magazine. Funny shit. Then Eve Torres comes in, pours some baby powder on her hair. Then we got a nice little beatdown, which is going to set up a little match later on in the night. It was an alright promo. And then we go on to, Buzz Aldrin, I'm sorry, buddy. You're just not really doing it. I mean, this whole guest host thing, I mean, sometimes it's a hit, sometimes it's a miss. This was a complete fucking bomb. One of the only really negatives of this show was Buzz Aldrin. But he did bring up one good point, at least it was written in for him, that Vicky Guerrero, you know, she comes in and he says that she quit last week, so she's through. And they're going to have a new GM next week. A permanent GM. Interesting to see where this goes, and in fact, drop your comments here. Who should be the new full-time general manager of Raw starting next week? And let's go on to the, this wasn't a match. This was a beatdown by Batista, or Dave Berg on the Kool-Aid man, Mark Henry. Like I said, what match? It was supposed to be a match. It comes down with a 2x4, beats the shit out of him. Just a good beatdown. Way to build some heat from the pay-per-view. Goes for the spotlight promo. Again, a well-played angle. Good job. Some other funny shit happened here with the R-Truth commercial. That's right, the R-Truth commercial. Priceless. Simply priceless. That's all I got to say about that. Then we've got our third match of the night, which is Teddy DeBusey, that's right, with the real Virgil. Fucked up he was wearing a white beater, just a regular white t-shirt. But hey, he still looks good. He's like pushing 50 years old if he's not 50 already. Someone will tell me his real age by Wikipedia-ing him up, I'm sure. And he's fighting Super Yoshi World. That's right. This is a short match. It went for 3 minutes. DeBusey picks up the win with the Dream Street. A nice short match. Way to continue his feud with R-Truth, which I think they're building a nice feud here. Mm-hmm.